जी बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्न एंड ग्रो विद फराज। टुडेज वीडियो विल बी इंक्लूडेड इन द सीरीज ऑफ कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर। इट विल बी इंक्लूडेड इन द प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर एंड यू कैन फाइंड आवर प्रीवियस वीडियोस ऑन द सेम चैनल इन द सेम प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर। सो विदाउट कास्टिंग एनी डिले, लेट मी स्टार्ट माई टूडेज डिस्कशन। इट विल बी ऑन Chapter number 9 of the book Consumer Behavior by Leon G. Skiffman. And the name of the chapter is Communication and Consumer Behavior. What we will be learning in this video, these are the learning objectives: to understand the role of message source in the communication process. We will understand the role of message's audience, the receiver, in the communication process. Then we will be learning about advertisement and media and how to select the right media for advertisement when sending promotional messages targeting selected consumers, how selected consumers are targeted. Then we will be learning how to understand consumer and how understanding consumers enables us or the enables the marketers to develop persuasive messages, the messages to persuade. Then understand how marketers measure the effectiveness of their promotional campaigns and promotional messages. First of all, this is an advertisement. This is for your brainstorming only. It is saying which type of communication is featured in this ad and what strategy concept does it get across. You need to actually think about this ad and then you have to make conclusion according to your understanding. Basically, this ad is showing non-verbal use for positioning. Basically, these are non-verbal. Non-verbal means you are not using words. Like, I am using my words and I am also using my body language. So, non-verbal where you are not using words. So, non-verbal use for positioning. Then, basic communication model. Here, you are given with the basic communication model. There is a source, which is a sender. It encodes the message, it sends the message, message goes through a channel or medium, and the receiver receives the message, which actually decodes the message and gives you the feedback. I will be reading here in the top down. Before we begin talking about the communication in more detail, it is worth taking to look at a basic communication model. What we see here is someone, the source, sending a message through a channel to a receiver, most likely the consumer who is actually viewing your message or receiving your message. The model also shows that there is a feedback from the receiver which tells the sender whether the message was received. So there is also a feedback mechanism. Okay, let's move to our next slide. The source as the initiator. Basically, it will be talking about formal communication sources and informal communication sources. Formal communication sources are marketer or organization. In the formal ways, things are communicated to the consumer in a more formalized way, in a more official way. For example, a marketer or the organization communicates you through formal communication source. However, on the other side, informal source, for example, a parent, a friend, or other consumer or your parent actually discusses about the product. So it is the informal source. Okay. Let me read it from the top down panel. It is important to understand that the sender of the message can be formal or informal source. As I told you about formal and difference between the formal and informal source, informal sources have become of interest to marketers as consumers look online to find rating from other consumers when taking in marketing information. Informal sources, they are very interesting. They are becoming interesting for the marketers because most of the time, consumer actually approaches other consumers to get the information about the product or to know the experience that one consumer have one consumer has from the product. So this is informal source. So it is of great interest. Next slide, the sources. Then sources can be impersonal and interpersonal. Impersonal and interpersonal sources, what does it mean? Let me read it. A message can either be impersonal and transmitted to many or interpersonal, which involves more one-on-one communication. When you are talking to your friend, you are actually doing an interpersonal communication. And when you are sending this message to many people, this is impersonal message. Like I am talking to you through this video. So this is an impersonal message. In either case, it is important to consider how credible the source might be. As they seen as honest and objective, are they well respected? So it actually gives us about the credibility of the sources. Then reference group. First one is source credibility. The sources should be credible. They should be trustworthy. Then the sources. Other one is reference group. What are reference groups? Reference groups are considered very credible source since they help define a person's behavior. For instance, your family or your friend give you a sense of what you buy, where to eat, and the type of clothes to wear to a given event. Right? These are normative groups, normative reference groups. Comparative reference groups are also set benchmarks, but for much narrower part of your lifestyle. People often become members of group like fraternity and influenced by other members' purchases. Finally, a symbolic group is one in which you are not a member but take on the values and attitude of the group. I will explain these one by one for you. Okay. First one is normative groups. Normative groups is where you, the group member to whom you share your norms, for example, your family or your close friends, which actually share norms with you. So you take the opinion or you take the suggestions from your normative groups, and then you make your decision, and then communication process completes. Normative groups influences your norms, attitude, and values through direct interaction. Examples of your normative reference groups include your parents, your siblings, teachers, peers, associates, and friends. They actually share their experiences of a product with you, and then you decide to buy or not to buy that product. Then a comparative reference group. It is a group with which one compares themselves. For example, they might not shape the beliefs or norms, but one may feel drawn to be more like them. For example, many young children idolize superheroes. Comparative groups basically give you an inkling that with which you compare yourself. For example, the children or the teenagers, they like to idealize themselves, or they like to idealize their superheroes, and they like to be just behave like their superheroes, and it actually communicates a message from their superheroes to those ones. Then informal sources and words of mouth. Informal sources are opinion leaders. Informal sources have a lot of influence on consumers because they appear to have nothing to gain from their recommendations. Opinion leaders tend to be a category specific. Opinion leaders is a category specific group of informal source and specialize in the area in which they offer information and advice. Word of mouth is usually a two-way process that commonly takes place online through social networks, brand communities, and message board and blogs. Blogs are so popular, in fact, that there are several search engines for blogs, including this web link, Technorati, a blog search engine. Technorati basically is a blog search engine, and mostly people go to the blogs of the product. And from those blogs, they get information about the product, and then they make the decision to buy or not to buy a product. Then word of mouth. Word of mouth marketing happens when consumers talk about a company's product or services to their friends, family, and other with whom they have close relationship. When I buy a product, I would like to share my experience with my family members or my friends or my siblings or other. So this is basically word of mouth marketing. Either I am appreciating my purchase to my family members, or I am discouraging them to buy the product if I'm not satisfied. So this is word of mouth marketing. Word of mouth marketing is one of the most powerful form of advertising, as 88% of consumer trust their friends' recommendation over traditional media. So word of mouth is very important, and it is very from strategic point of view, word of mouth marketing is a very important concept. More than 88% of the consumers, they trust the word of mouth of their friends and families in order to buy a product. So it is very important. Then companies can encourage word of mouth marketing by exceeding expectations on a product, providing good customer service, and giving exclusive information to the consumers. In this way, companies actually can encourage positive word of mouth by giving good customer service, by giving exclusive information to their consumers, giving every information about the product to the consumers. It will encourage word of mouth marketing. Then the World of Mouth Marketing Association, WOMMA, cites the best word of mouth marketing strategies as being honest, credible, and social, repeatable, measurable, and respectful. If you are having those factors in your word of mouth marketing, then your word of mouth marketing strategy will be very fruitful and very useful for your marketing campaign. Word of mouth marketing includes various marketing techniques such as buzz, blogs, and social media marketing. So those are some techniques which are used in word of mouth marketing. I will end my lecture here. I will once again request you that you should subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed it before. Thank you very much for watching my video. Inshallah, see you again in the next video.